Thank God it's Monday. Today, we're going to look at Matthew 16, which was sermon of yesterday, and we're going to apply it to every day of our week. In Matthew 16, verse 13, Jesus talks about, who do people say that I am? He asks that his disciples, and his disciples, they respond with public figures of the present or the past. So, you know, Elijah or Jeremiah or John the Baptist or one of the prophets, which in their roles of that time would have been similar to how people respond today. If you ask them on the street, who do you think that Jesus is? Some will respond, you know, he was a very inspired teacher. Or they would say things like, he was a moral person. He was a very good person. Or they would say things like, yeah, maybe he did miraculous things, right? Like Elijah. Or maybe he was a revolutionary like John the Baptist. So the answers of that time were not much different than today. They're just different names. Jesus then proceeds and asks, now who do you say that I am? Not think, not feel, not believe. He says, say. Because when he says that, when then, you know, Peter opens his mouth as the first one, like always, and says, you know, you're the Christ, the Son of the living God. He confesses something of the nature of Jesus, namely that he is Lord and that he is fully man, fully God. And with that, he kickstarts church. Because then Jesus says, oh, blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, because flesh and blood has not revealed that to you, but my Father who is in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church. Now, with church, he says, the word is community. It was a political term, had nothing to do with religious belief system or so. He also, when he makes this play of words about rock and Peter, the rock that he's referring to is the revelation of who Jesus is and the confession with our mouths. Peter is just a stone. He's just adding to the building, to the stone of living people. Later on, Peter would write about us being living stones, being added to this, you know, holy nation, this building, this temple that is made out of living stones, where Jesus is the foundational cornerstone. Now, with that being said, this is the starting point of church. Where does it start? It's when people have a revelation of who Jesus is. That's something that God has to give us. And that's something that I think sometimes needs to come fresh again. Jesus has to give you a fresh revelation of who he is. God has to give that to you. The Father in heaven has to reveal that to you. Flesh and blood will not do it. But then our part is actually to say who he is. We have to learn how to confess Jesus. I think evangelizing has become a dirty word. People have felt in today's, you know, it's like the worst thing you can do is proselytize or you know, get other people to believe what you believe and those things. And the gospel has become, I don't know, not good news anymore. If you have good news, you share it, right? Now, the good news is that Jesus has transcended death through resurrection. That was the good news that the people had with Peter and the apostles. And that's why they didn't give up when Jesus had left them. That's how the church got started. He is the Son of the living God, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. Death will not be overcome by Jesus. So with that, let me ask you this question. When was the last time you discovered something new about Jesus? Second one, when was the last time you confessed Jesus? Now, the first one should not put pressure on you. The first one should give you hunger, right? And so if you're in a connect group, why don't you spend time asking God, reveal yourself to me, but also to the people that I want, you know, to be reached by you. Reveal yourself, Lord, to them. Secondly, discuss where in your realm, where you are, can you confess Jesus in what way? What would be a practical step towards building the community of faith, hope, and love that he is building in this world? Tough question. Hope you have a wonderful week and get to apply this every day. May God reveal himself to you every day, and may God give you the strength to confess him as Lord. God bless you guys. Have a wonderful week.